As forests are cut down to make way for urban developments, many species of wildlife and their natural habitats are fast disappearing. Tigers, orangutans, and cotton-top tamarins are just some of these endangered species. However, at the Singapore Zoo, these animals are bred, fed well, and taken care of. The zoo is home to over 315 species, of which 29% are threatened. They are kept in a controlled environment to ensure their growth and survival. But while some say that wild animals are well looked after in the zoos, others feel that they are better off in the wild where they belong. When Razor TV asked people if there were alternative ways of conserving animals, most felt that wild zoos were a safe place, safari parks or wildlife reserves would also make feasible alternatives.
To me, the zoo is for educational and entertainment purposes. If you didn't have a zoo, people... it'd be pretty hard for people to actually find out, like, read more about the animals or, like, find out more about them.
Leave them in the zoo. It's more safer.
I mean, there are better ways to keep them around, right? To prevent them from getting extinct. Like, you can keep them in wildlife reserves, but it's just that Singapore, we don't have space.
If they have space, definitely, like, put them in the wild to and observe them from afar would be good.
Yeah, I went to for a canyon safari once. Yeah, and you really see animals in their real... in like real life, and it's quite amazing. It's as close as you're going to get to seeing real nature, but I guess it's one step further towards nature than zoo.
Animal activists say that there are good and bad zoos. While good zoos help in conservation and raising awareness about animals, bad zoos are guilty of animal cruelty.
So there are good zoos and then there are substandard zoos. And the reality is that 90% of zoos in the world today are substandard. There are only 10% that fit into optimal level of welfare for the animals. Okay, we're not saying we're totally against zoos or we want to close the zoos down, but we're saying let's focus on species that can do well. And a lot of zoos are starting to do this now. So if you go to Australia, a lot of zoos are now focusing on marsupials. They don't have anything but marsupials so that people can understand what's in their own country and protect what's in their own country.
Well, of course, ultimately we'll say that wild animals belong in the wild, you know. But, zoos have been around for so long already. And I think more the issue for SPCA would be, you know, is a zoo up to standard? It must be as much, their surroundings should be as much like their natural habitat.
Many species in the world are on the verge of extinction. Good zoos with a strong conservation focus can provide a good and safe home for endangered animals. The problem is a pressing one. According to the International Union for Conservation of Nature's Red List, 1 in 4 mammals, 1 in 8 birds, 1/3 of all amphibians are endangered. The total number of extinct species has reached 785 in the last 500 years. Good zoos, safari parks, and nature reserves make animal conservation possible. Animal rights groups and animal lovers also do their part by speaking out against the wildlife trade, as well as animal shows that border on cruelty. With these efforts, one can only hope that these proud and beautiful creatures continue to live on even as the world rapidly modernizes.